You're all fine. Now, in this lesson, we will study electrons and chemical bonding. Actually, I mentioned it in the previous video. I will continue again. Maybe we will go a little bit deep. Now, bond change. How do atoms join together? A huge variety of substances are possible because atoms join together by forming chemical bonds. Okay, as I mentioned it while explaining atoms. What I said, number of the atoms, number of the elements actually, so less in the nature. Okay, 118. How about the number of the substances? A lot. Why? Because those atoms comes together, make a chemical bond, and they produce different substances like oxygen, like carbon dioxide, like water, right? Do you see? In the water, there are two types of the atoms, and they come together, and they produce different compound. You see here, carbon dioxide, two oxygen, one carbon comes together and produce different compound. You see, actually, number of the substances is very rich because because of the chemical bond. What is chemical bond? A chemical bond is an interaction that holds atoms and ions together. When they do chemical reaction, they do chemical bond between them. Okay, here you are able to see there is a chemical bond. That's why carbon and oxygen are kept together. A group of atoms that are held together by chemical bond is called a molecule. Okay? The number of the, actually there should be more than one atom to be a molecule. Here there are five atoms, there are three atoms, that's why they are called molecule. Okay? Yeah. What happens to atoms during chemical changes? Chemical changes change the identity of substances. As I explained you before, oxygen and carbon. Okay? When they both come together, they produce carbon dioxide. It is completely different. For example, oxygen and hydrogen. They come together to produce water. And water is completely different from the oxygen gas and hydrogen gas, right? They're all reactant actually. They cause fire mostly. Without oxygen, you cannot get fire, right? You cannot burn the wood, for example, without oxygen. You see, it caused the fire, but water doesn't. It is physical and chemical. Actually, property has been changed. Chemical changes do not create or destroy atoms. In a chemical change, atoms are rearranged to make new substances with different properties. For example, salt. When you put salt inside of the water, what happens? It is actually separated into ions. Have you destroyed the atoms inside of the salt? No. What happens? That just they are rearranged. Okay? For example, when you burn the wood, what happens? The wood is burned and the atoms are not lost. The total mass is not lost. You cannot destroy the atoms in the chemical reaction and you cannot actually create the atom. The number of the total atom is same. The gas, the smoke, as well as ash of the dead element completely equal to previous element which is burned. Understand? After burning, actually the mass is not lost. You didn't destroy any atoms, just atoms are converted into gas. Like also food, okay? When we eat. When we eat the food, actually the food, for example, apple, is converted into carbon dioxide. That's all. When you use as an energy, you burn the food, glucose, sugar in your mitochondria, and it is converted into what? Gas, carbon to oxygen, carbon dioxide, and you release outside. You see, apple is converted into a gas. Gas is converted into apple in the plant. You see the system, great system, right? Plants actually produce the food from gas. Which machine is able to do that? In order for atoms to be rearranged, you see, rearranging of the atoms cause actually new substances. New substances. Okay? Chemical bonds have to be formed or broken down. So simple, right? Actually, what? Chemical bonds are broken down and energy is released. Chemical are, bonds are actually produced in the plants. That's why apple is produced. You got it? What do different atom models show? Now, the electron cloud model of an atom shows how electrons are found in a region around the nucleus. This model helps to show the general location of the different parts of the atom. However, it does not show the number of the electrons. As you see here, number of the electrons are not seen, just location of the each and of the sub, each and every subparticles are able to be seen in the electron cloud model. Okay, we are not able to see the number of the atoms, but in Bohr model we will study it. You see, number of the electrons can be seen. Okay, where are the nucleus and the electrons in the electron cloud model in the lithium atom? It is so simple question. Here is the electron cloud model, and electrons are present in it, and the nucleus is over here, where the protons and neutrons are present. How about the Bohr model? The Bohr model of the atom shows the number of electrons in an atom. You see, number of the electrons can be seen. The electrons are shown as dots placed in rings around the nucleus, which with each ring representing an energy level. You see, this is the first energy level, this is the second energy level. If it is different type of the element which has more protons and electrons, there will be third energy level, fourth energy level, fifth energy level, sixth energy level, etc. Okay, now here, showing the electrons in energy levels helps predict how and why atoms form chemical bonds. Okay, you see, in the first energy level, mostly two electrons are present, maximum two electrons can be present. In the second energy level, maximum there can be, eight electron on it. And over here, you are able to see in this oxygen atom, there are six electrons in this second energy level. And this element needs to be, needs to have actually eight electrons in this last energy level as a valence electrons. Okay? Valence electrons are the electrons which are present on the outermost layer of the atom. Here is the outermost layer, and the electron number of the electrons are, two missing. That's why it makes chemical bonds with another one and use their electrons on the last energy level to actually reach the number 8 electrons. And we are able to understand that it has to do two bonds to get two electrons. That's why what happens? Two hydrogen actually make a chemical bond with the oxygen and produce water. How are electrons distributed in the Bohr model of an oxygen level? You see, oxygen atom. You see, in the first one, two, in the second one, six. If it would be another element, what will happen? In the first one, two. If it has more electrons, in the first energy level, two. In the second energy level, six. Not six, definitely it will be eight. In the third energy level, maximum how many electrons can be present? 18. Okay, in the third one. In the fourth one, 32. In the fifth one, 32. In the sixth one, 18 again. Okay, Then in the seventh one, eight again. And in the eighth one, again two. You see, actually you don't need to memorize them all because, you know, we will study with the smaller atoms, smaller elements. That's why it will be easier to